installation of the Stryker low and mean rear fender. First, you need to obviously remove the stock rear fender. Start off by taking off the seat. You're going to have to unplug the fender wiring harness, which is underneath this left side cover. So removal of the left side cover has to be done simply by pulling this Allen bolt out, pulling that cover out of the way, and unplugging the plug. The plug's routed up in front of the battery and under this frame tube, so you're going to want to pull that all out of the way to get ready to remove the rear fender. The rear fender has two body pins here that you simply push in the center of them and pull them out, and then two bolts on each side. After removing all that, you're going to want to take out your top mounting bolts, including this rear seat fastener. Remove all that, and the fender will be able to slide straight off the back of the motorcycle. Once the stock fender is removed, we're going to get ready to install the new low and mean rear fender. The installation of the low and mean fender is slightly different from stock. It's held on mainly by black RTV silicone. The only hardware you're going to reuse are the two body panel pins that hold the fender itself to the inner fender. So before we put the rear fender in place, you're going to put a liberal amount of silicone directly across these two cross members and in contact points, any point that contacts the inside of the fender. A little bit back here on each corner and a little bit right here on the front of each of these frame rails. When you purchase the Stryker fender from Low & Mean, you get an LED that goes on the back of the fender. The LED has double-sided sticky tape on the back of it, and it's easily installed into this channel, running the lights through their hole and wiring them as per the instructions in the kit. Also, the fender comes completely smooth with no holes drilled in it, but that's only going to work with our low and mean seat. If you plan on using your stock seat or switching back and forth between the low and mean seat and your stock seat, these holes will have to be drilled out to allow installation of your stock seat rear bracket. This. If you opt to have the holes drilled out, we do offer chrome push-in caps that are easily pushed into these holes to cover the holes when you're not using the stock seat. The fender can be ordered with or without holes depending on which seat you choose to use. Make sure the wiring harness is glued to the fender in a position to where it's up out of the way and not being squished by either one of these frame rails. Holding the wires out of the way, we'll put the fender in place. Snap the body panel pins. That'll keep the fender in place. You can see we've installed these chrome push plugs. Usually they'll stick in using that existing silicone that you smeared across the top of that frame rail. We put them in to cover those holes. If you're using your stock seat or any kind of passenger seat, you can of course utilize these holes for the mounting hardware, or you can put bolts in these holes if you think it's necessary. After that, you simply reroute your wiring the same way you pulled it out. Take it in around the front of the battery and back into its plug under the left side cover.